Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we saw the component parts of a centrifugal pump. Okay. So the important parts that we saw were, okay, first is the suction pipe. Okay. The work of the suction pipe is to suck the water from the sump. Okay, this sump. Okay, this is the sump. That is the water at a lower elevation. Okay, we suck the water through the help of a suction pipe. Okay, up to the impeller. Okay, this is the impeller. Now, suction pipe also consists of two other terms. That is strainer and foot valve. Okay. Now, the work of strainer is that while the suction pipe is sucking the water, no solid particles come along with the water inside the pump. Otherwise, the whole assembly can get destroyed. Okay. Now, second component of the suction pipe is the foot valve. Okay. The foot valve is also known as a one-sided valve or a non-return valve. Okay. This is because from this valve only water can enter inside the pump. Okay, but water cannot leave the pump. Okay, so water can only enter the pump from the foot valve, but it cannot come outside from inside the pump. Okay, so this was the part of suction pipe. Next, from the suction pipe the water enters the eye of the impeller. Okay, eye of the impeller, okay, is the middle or the central portion of the impeller. Okay, now what is impeller? It is a wheel consisting of curved backward vanes. Okay, these are the curved backward vanes. Okay, now at the center of that impeller is the eye of the impeller. So the water from the suction pipe enters the eye of the impeller and then it gets rotated through this impeller. Okay, and it leaves the impeller and it joins the outer casing. This is the outer casing, and from the outer casing it comes out through the delivery pipe to the overhead tank. Okay, so these are all our important components. Okay, now we'll study how this happens. Okay, we'll study the working of centrifugal pump. Okay. A centrifugal pump works on the principle that rise in pressure head is directly proportional to tangential velocity. Okay. Now, if we see here, if we just observe the casing, we can see that at the beginning the diameter or the area of the casing is very small. Okay. This area is very small. Okay, this area is very small, but as we go forward, what happens? The area of the casing goes on increasing. Okay, so what happens? Due to rotation of the water in the impeller, a centrifugal force is applied on the water by the impeller. Now this water rotates in a radial form. Okay, and it has a tangential velocity, not a linear velocity but a tangential velocity. Okay, now here at this point the tangential velocity is the maximum. Okay, now as we go forward the tangential velocity goes on decreasing. Why? Because we know as the area goes on increasing the velocity goes on decreasing. Okay, so this here velocity will go on decreasing, but from the continuity equation we know that the, or from the Bernoulli's equation we will know that this discharge will not decrease due to decrease in velocity, but the tangential velocity will get converted into the pressure head. Okay, and this pressure head will rise through the delivery pipe and it will come out in the overhead tank. Okay. So we'll see the working of centrifugal pump. First, the delivery valve is closed. Okay, so this here is the delivery valve. In the beginning it is closed, okay, and the pump is primed. Okay, now priming the pump means below this delivery valve, from this delivery valve up to this foot valve, okay, we fill the pump assembly with water. Okay, we do not leave it dry, we'll fill the whole assembly with water. That is known as the priming of the pump. Okay, so suction, the pump is primed, that is suction pipe, casing and portion of the delivery pipe up to the delivery valve are completely filled with the liquid to be pumped, so that no air pocket is left, as I said. Now second step is, keeping the delivery valve still closed, the electric motor is started to rotate the impeller. The rotation of the impeller causes strong suction or vacuum just at the eye of the casing. Okay, now keeping this delivery valve cased, in the second step what we'll do is, we will start the electric motor. Now when the electric motor is started, this impeller starts rotating. Okay, now due to the rotation of this impeller, okay, a suction is created or a vacuum is created at this eye. Okay, at the center of the impeller, this is the eye of the impeller, at the eye a suction is created. Due to this suction, water gets sucked from the suction pipe up to the impeller, eye of the impeller. Okay, third step, the speed of the impeller is gradually increased till the impeller rotates at its normal speed and develops normal energy required for pumping the liquid. Okay, after the impeller attains the normal speed, the delivery valve is then opened. When the liquid is continuously sucked up the suction pipe. Okay, now as the water is, or as the fluid is being sucked up the suction pipe, we will open the delivery valve. Okay, the liquid is impelled out by the rotating vanes of the impeller and it comes out at the outlet tips of the vane into the casing. Okay, so what happens? So as the vane of the impeller is rotating, the water due to centrifugal action will come out of the vanes from the outlet tips and it will join the casing. Okay, now they will travel through the outside casing and they'll go up to the delivery pipe. Here the delivery valve is open now. Okay, now as the casing has increasing area, okay, the area goes on increasing of the casing. What happens in the beginning, the velocity is greater. As we go forward, the velocity goes on decreasing, and in that case the pressure head goes on increasing. Okay, now from the casing the liquid passes into the pipe and is lifted to the required height and discharged from the outlet. Okay, the liquid is lifted through the required height up to the overhead tank from the delivery pipe. Okay, now when the pump is to be stopped, the delivery valve should be closed first, otherwise there may be some backflow from the reservoir. Okay, when the pump is to be stopped, this delivery pipe is to be closed, or what will happen, the water from the overhead tank will come back in the pump. Okay, so this is the working of centrifugal pump. Okay, so what we saw in the working of the centrifugal pump, okay, first what we'll do is, we will keep the delivery valve closed. Keeping the delivery valve closed, what we'll do is, we will prime the pump, that is up from the delivery valve, from the delivery valve up to the this foot valve, up to this foot valve, the pump will be completely filled with water. Okay, now what will happen, keeping the delivery valve closed, we will start the motor, electric motor. Now when the electric motor starts, this impeller goes on rotating. Okay, now due to this impeller rotating, there is a suction or a vacuum created at the eye of this impeller. Okay, this is the eye of the impeller. Okay, a suction is created. Okay, now due to the suction created or the vacuum created, water will be sucked from the sump through the suction pipe to the eye of the impeller. Okay, now when the water enters the eye of the impeller, okay, we'll open the delivery valve. Okay, we'll open the delivery valve. Okay, so now what will happen? Here the water will rotate, and due to centrifugal action, it will be thrown out of the impeller, and it will go from the casing up to the delivery pipe. Okay, here what happens is, here initially the velocity, the area is less, so the velocity is greater, and here the velocity is greater, so the here the area is greater, so the velocity is less. So in this case, the tangential velocity is converted into pressure head. Okay, so now we'll start with the classification of pump. Okay, on the basis of characteristic features, the centrifugal pumps are classified as, first, they are classified on the basis of types of casing. First is the volute pump. Volute pump, okay, this is an example of volute pump in which the area of the casing goes on increasing gradually. Okay, now, and second is the turbine pump, in which the area remains constant throughout, area of the casing remains constant throughout. Now, second classification is based on working head. Okay, there are three types of centrifugal pumps in that. First is the low lift centrifugal pump, okay, which can work up to head of 15 meter. Okay, that means this pump can lift water up to a height of only 15 meters. Okay, now second is the medium lift centrifugal pump. This pump can lift water as high as 40 meter. And third is the high lift centrifugal pump, which can lift water above height of 40 meters. Third classification is based on the liquid handled. Okay, there are three types again: closed impeller pump, semi open impeller pump, and open impeller pump. Okay, now in this case, in closed impeller pump, okay, when the liquid is of low viscosity, for example water, okay, so in that case we can use closed impeller pump. Okay, now open impeller pump, okay, in which the fluid is more clogged, it can get clogged. Okay, for example some solid liquid mixture, okay, which can get clogged in the impeller, in that case we use open impeller pump. Okay, and semi open impeller pump is used for the liquid in between both of them. Okay, now number of impellers per shaft. Okay, in next classification, fourth classification is based on numbers of impellers per shaft. Okay, now the impeller is connected to a single shaft which is connected to an electric motor. Okay, now on that shaft we can use a single impeller, and it is known as a single stage centrifugal pump. Okay, they are required for, say, a pump which are not required to raise the water up to a greater height. Okay, now for a single shaft we can apply multiply impellers, we can attach multiply impellers. Okay, and that is known as a multi-stage centrifugal pump which has two or more impellers. Okay, they are usually used for high working heads. Okay, usually used for high working heads. And the last classifications are, first on the basis of, fifth is number of entrances to the impeller, whether the water is entering from the suction to the impeller from a single point or from two points. Okay, from a single point then it is known as single suction pump, and from two points it is known as double suction pump. And last is the relative direction of flow through the impeller. Okay, in that we have three types: radial flow, okay, in which the impellers in the impellers the water flows radially, in the axial flow pump the water flows axially, and in the mixed flow pump there is a mixture of axial flow as well as radial flow. Okay, so guys, this was